You're listening to a Weeby Geeks Network podcast.
Another world, another time, in the age of wonder.
There was once a dream. You could only whisper it. Anything more than a whisper, and it would vanish.
A battle between good and evil.
You don't know the power of the dark side.
Where shall I find a new adversary so close to my own level?
Try the local sewer.
You know of the rebellion against the Empire?
The Avengers, Earth's mightiest heroes.
Peace means having a bigger stick than the other guy.
One of these days, I'm gonna have a stick of my own.
I'm Groot.
Welcome to the Neverland podcast. The podcast for lovers of Disney, Pixar, Marvel, and Star Wars.
I'm glad you're here to tell us these things.
Please welcome your host, Jeremy.
I thought he'd be taller.
Yeah, I can fly.
All it takes is faith. Trust.
Well, if it isn't the Star Spangled Man with a plan, what is your plan today?
Up to Neverland!
Pick your pixies out of your pockets, Neverlanders. Sprinkle some of that pixie dust around, grab your happiest thought, and let's fly away to Neverland. Of course, you know me. I am your Spider-Pan Jeremy, your host of the Neverland podcast, and, well, I am the pan here in Neverland, so kind of the leader of the Lost Boys, which, by the way, have you officially joined us yet? We do have on the website, neverlandpodcast.com. If you click on Neverlanders, you can officially become a Lost Boy or Pixie. So why are they pixies and not lost girls? Because girls are too clever and they don't get lost. So make sure you come and check out the website. Also, make sure you're checking out our YouTube channel. Because on the YouTube channel, I have been live streaming my first time playing Kingdom Hearts. I've recently purchased the PS4 Kingdom Hearts 1.5 and 2.5, which is supposed to be having, you know, it's got like the official final version, the final cuts, and it's all in high def. And I tell you what, I'm having a heck of a time getting through the first Kingdom Hearts. So I think part of the fun of watching me play Kingdom Hearts is the fact that I really don't know what I'm doing half the time. I've got no instruction manual that I think the original version probably would have come with. So I am just learning and figuring this thing out as I go along. And I tell you, I'm having a hard time. So you can actually watch me as I play, as I kind of stop and you might see it pause. And it just kind of sits there. And that's me going to Google because I'm confused about something. Because there are bits in the controls and how to do things and how to work your inventory that nothing has shown me how to do. And in fact, the most recent stream, I was still trying to figure out how your gummy ship works and the blueprints and how to put stuff together. Which I think I finally figured some of that out. So every time I play that, I learn something new that I don't quite understand. And so I'm, you know, gaining new abilities all the time. I'm only ever able to play on the weekends because of my busy schedule, and I tell you what, it's a difficult game. I gotta say, I'm having some fun with it, but some of it is I've played better games than this. The boss fights, they seem to have, you know, there's a weak point you want to hit, and so far the most innovative thing about hitting that weak point is jump, and then you get lucky if you actually make contact. And I was expecting it to be a little bit more, you know, Legend of Zelda, when you've got a weak point on a boss, but you have to maybe do something to unlock that weak point. Then you attack, attack, attack. But there's something of some fun to it. This is more like just a whack, whack, whack. But Squaresoft, you know, they're used to doing turn-based things in Final Fantasy games, I guess. And this, as far as I can tell, is maybe their first attempt at this style of an RPG. So I think maybe they were still finding their footing on making it really good, perhaps. I don't know. So that's the boss fights have not been that fun for me. They've been kind of like really repetitive, and I'm like, I don't know, I'm not really having fun with this. And I got stuck on the last boss with Cerberus, which I've made some mistakes of having Donald and Goofy. I've been handing them potions to carry their inventory, and I don't know if I've got them on the proper setting, because they're burning through potions like you wouldn't believe. I thought I set them for emergency use only, but they're constantly in emergency because their superpower is to get their butts kicked. So, every time I get into a boss fight or something, Donald is the first to go down, and Goofy comes to his rescue, burning up one of my potions. And now I don't have any potions, and I gotta go fight Cerberus, and I have no money to go buy any more potions to go fight the Cerberus. So, next week I have to figure out what I'm gonna do about this. So, I am definitely having my struggles, and those of you that have played these games for years can watch me struggle and say, wow, this guy really doesn't know what he's doing. So it's either going to be funny or you're going to be sitting there pulling your hair out like, why don't you just do this? So, but we've been doing that all completely on YouTube. But as you may have noticed, I'm by myself this week. Eric, unfortunately, has a migraine. I completely understand how those are. Pixie Heather gets those as well. And so you just need some peace and quiet and some darkness. And so that's why he's not here to tell us about his recent birthday and anniversary trip to Walt Disney World, which was his first time going to Walt Disney World. So he's got lots of stories, I'm sure, to share with us. What he has sent so far, though, I've got some audio. He went to Port Orleans to hear Yehaa Bob play, and we're going to listen to that audio today. It's a little over an hour long, so that's pretty much going to cover the entire length of the average show. But before we jump to that audio, I definitely wanted to talk a little bit about some of the news that's been happening this week.
Spanning the Disney and geek universe to bring you the best in comics, toys, movies, and entertainment. This is news from around Neverland.
Okay, so first thing we're probably going to have to mention, because it happened actually right after I released the episode, I saw this, but Arlie Ermey passed away on Sunday. And for Disney fans, I think the primary thing we're going to think of him for is being Sarge in the Toy Story series. Thanks to Saturday Morning Rewind and Tim Nidell, I've gotten to see a lot of clips that they have a nice YouTube video tribute, and you can see him being on Kim Possible and some other Disney shows and a lot of other non-Disney shows. This week also saw the passing of Harry Anderson, who people my age will remember him as Judge Harry T. Stone on Night Court and a lot of other things. The original Stephen King, It, that was a television movie with Tim Curry as the clown. Just a lot of different things. I don't think he ever did any work for Disney that I can find, but he was a perfect Disney-style actor as a comedian and magician. He was just a lot of fun, and he will be missed. Of course, we've missed him for years because we haven't really seen him. He opened up a comedy club and was running that, and so he'd kind of stepped out of the limelight a long time ago. So then, of course, we lost Barbara Bush this week. I mean, this was a week of loss. And also, I just found out on Friday that classic WWE, well, it wasn't the WWE at the time, but Bruno Sammartino, one of the original legends of wrestling. I mean, he was one of the longest-running champions they'd ever had back in the old-time wrestling even probably before I was watching, I think, it was Bruno Sammartino. And he's a WWE Hall of Famer and just a legend. And I didn't hear a big to-do about it, but I was guest starring on Stuff I Didn't Know, which is a trivia podcast. We were doing just a live video. I don't know if he's going to release the audio. I've been on his show a couple of times, but I was playing trivia. The host, Jeff, there lives in Philadelphia, and Bruno Sammartino is from Philadelphia, so it was kind of a big thing for them. So a lot of loss this week. But as we are moving on, in fact, there was even another guy that passed away that we'll talk to. Well, let's just go into it now. This is kind of a big thing for Disney fans. Henry Landworth, at age 91, has passed away. He was the founder of Give Kids the World, which I've got a link, of course, on the Neverland Podcast website. He's a self-made millionaire, and he is a philanthropist who basically more than 160,000 children from all 50 states. He had a Kissimmee Resort Village that he opened in 1989, and these were like kids and their families of they were terminally ill children and their family, and they would all come. He would have a place for them to come and stay, and they'd all go to Walt Disney World and even Universal and probably some of the other parks in that area. Just a really, really great philanthropic work. I love what he did there. I've got links on the Neverland Podcast website if you'd like to donate to Give Kids the World, because I think it's a wonderful thing that he did. And there's a really nice little thing in the Orlando Sentinel and a little paragraph that was very interesting. It said that he was born in Belgium in 1927 and actually imprisoned from age 13 to 18 by the Nazis, who separated him from his twin sister, killed his parents, stripped him of his name, and tattooed him with a number, B4343, etched into his left forearm. And then he was shuttled between labor and death camps, starved, beaten, and left for dead. so he had a really, really rough start to his life, but then became a self-made millionaire here in the States. And actually, in 1950, got drafted into the U.S. Army, so that's kind of funny. So he got to go and fight America's enemies after, you know, being through all that challenge. But he actually started Give Kids the World in 1986. And I think 1989 is when he got his current thing, Kissimmee, going. But he did a lot of great things. And so Give Kids the World, I'm sure, will continue without him. But now, something a little bit more perky. Okay, you probably know this was coming, but in case you forgot about this, Free Comic Book Day is coming, and it's May 5th this year. It's always that first Saturday in May. Normally, we have a Marvel movie that opens that Friday, but they moved Avengers Infinity War up to April 27th, 1 week ahead. Oh, which, by the way, that's this week when you're hearing this. So guess what we're going to talk about next week? It's going to be great. But I had a look here at some of the things that are being offered up. You're going to have to get to your shop early to get some of these, but there is an Avengers Captain America for Free Comic Book Day. There's a Disney Princess from Joe Books spotlighting Ariel. That's going to be of interest to us. Let's see. There's a Doctor Who comic I'm going to be interested in. A lot of other different things, like Power Rangers and Pokemon and things like that. But mainly, of course, being Disney fans, we're interested, of course, in Avengers and Disney Princesses. There's also in the silver books, because there's like a gold edition and there's silver edition. And, you know, I haven't really looked through these silver ones to see if there was anything specific. I always like to grab the Bongo comics because it has all kinds of different characters in there. There are some Star Wars comics from IDW Publishing that's going to be there. So that, it looks like it's a tie-in to Solo when you look at the cover, because it does have a younger-looking Han Solo in the jacket we're seeing in the posters and things like that. An Amazing Spider-Man Infinity Watch. That might be linking up to the re-release of Amazing Spider-Man. Let's see, what else have we got here? And like I said, I'm kind of scanning through some of these first time. Of course, there is going to be some SpongeBob. Legend of Korra, I know, is going to be exciting to some. The Tick is going to have another. I always love these free Tick comics. I always grab these. But also, looky there. Tokyo Pop, The Nightmare Before Christmas, Zero's Journey, Chapter Zero. So, I don't know if this is all going to be released completely in the States, but this is a free comic. But it seems like there might be a Nightmare Before Christmas comic from Tokyo Pop that maybe we're going to get to see. So, that's going to be a manga style, I'm sure. But that's everything I can see that might be related to anything Marvel or Disney. There's, of course, going to be a lot of other comics that you're going to be interested in checking out. Free Comic Book Day, first Saturday in May, which this year is May 1st. I'm going to go out there and cover as much as I can. I'm sure Eric will be out there too. We'll have some things to tell you of what we managed to get, what we saw. There's always some fun things going on with this. So, yes, Free Comic Book Day, my favorite holiday other than like Christmas and my birthday and my anniversary. Because, yeah, Halloween is fun too, but I'm sorry, Free Comic Book Day, it's more fun than Halloween for me. Lin-Manuel Miranda fans are going to be excited to hear that he is Gizmo Duck in DuckTales, debuting May 11th. So a whole new generation of kids are going to get some Gizmo Duck, and it's Lin-Manuel Miranda. Now, I don't know that I'm that familiar with him as an actor. I know of him as a songwriter, and of course he did the music there for Moana, and everybody knows him, of course, from Hamilton, which has been going gangbusters. But May 11th, here we go. He's going to be on DuckTales as Gizmo Duck. So I'm really behind on this. This semester has been really rough, and I haven't really watched a whole lot of shows. There's even some DVD releases of the DuckTales new series on their way. All right, some quick other things from the parks. Fast Pass Plus has already opened up for the Toy Story. Special Magic Hours, World Resort, Hotel Guests, it's ready to go. And it's, of course, we know Toy Story Land is opening June 30th, but the reservations for Fast Pass Plus are already open for guests if you're staying at some of the Walt Disney World Resort hotels. That's where you have like 60 days. Now, whether your opinion is on you doing these Fast Passes this quick and this early and planning your trip around Fast Passes, whatever your opinion is on it, I understand. However, I'm just letting you know it's there, okay? So if you're going, get your Fast Passes. I bet by now they've probably even moved up. They've probably been taken away. Oh, but guess what? Up, The Great Bird Adventure actually has debuted as far as on the 22nd, Earth Day. It is now showing at Disney's Animal Kingdom. This, of course, was the update to the, what do they used to call it? The there was a free-flying bird show there before, and I forgot the name of it. But this is the replacement, and so now we have Doug and Russell there with a lady who, the photo's here in the Disney Parks blog. She's in India-style dress with like a kind of peacock feather design. I don't know if they have any, you know, other style of hosts. So they have some men hosts and some women hosts and going back and forth. But this is all, of course, it's still a bird show, and you're going to get to see all kinds of different birds. It's 25 minutes long, but this time we have some characters in there. So that's pretty exciting. I'd like to check it out. I don't know if Eric got a chance to check this out. He would have been there on that day, I believe. No, wait, today's April 22nd, Earth Day. How about that? So, no, Eric is already back home, so no, he's not going to have any audio of that, unfortunately. So, I'm sure there'll be some video. There is even some video on the Parks blog. So this has actually debuted today as I'm recording this on April 22nd. I should look to see what day it is when I'm looking at these different articles. But, okay, there is a sweepstakes, by the way, if you want to go and check out Pixar Pier as a Disneyland resort vacation. No purchases necessary, and it ends on May 4th at 12 Pacific Daylight Time. And it's open, of course, to everybody here in the United States and Canada only, 18 plus, and you can enter once per day per person, okay? But this gets you into the parks. It is a four-day park hopper tickets, Disneyland VIP tour guide for a day, Disney gift card, hotel accommodations, round trip, coach airfare, 4 days, 3 nights at a Disneyland resort. This is fantastic. And you better believe I am trying to win this thing. And if I win, I will bring you as much information as I possibly can about this. In fact, while I'm sitting here, I realized I have not yet entered today. So I am now entering with my Disney account for yet another try. I don't know that I'm going to necessarily win this because I never win things like this. But you know what? I'm going to try. It's not costing me anything to attempt this, and it would be fantastic to win this. I really would be loving this. This would be a lot of fun because I've never been to Disneyland, and neither has my wife. So make sure you enter that. If you go to parks.disney.com/pixar-pier-getaway-sweepstakes. Yeah, I know that's a lot. It's all on the Disney Parks blog. But if you go to parksdisney.com, I'm sure you'll find some links to get you to the right place. But also now, being today is Earth Day, there is a new collection of products available to celebrate 20 years of Disney's Animal Kingdom. An I Was There collection. And there, of course, like t-shirts, hats, pins, really, really neat stuff. And even, I think it looks, I guess they're saying it's a special version of this. Well, it's in the rookery at Wind Traders, but they're these little, the Banshees. They're the little baby type versions or something, I guess they're supposed to have that you can normally buy, and they're like little puppets, but I guess they have some particular ones now for the 20th anniversary that's available. Very, very cool. There's also some really neat artwork that they're doing 20 with animals and doing like mosaic and really, really great artwork that's now on some of these t-shirts and mugs and coasters and picture frames and just all kinds of stuff that is now officially on sale at Disney's Animal Kingdom. But while you're at it and looking for stuff, this is probably already selling pretty fast. But tickets are available for the H2O Glow Nights, Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party, and Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party. The tickets are already on sale. And they, you know, this seems really early to think about this kind of thing, but this is when people are really, when people want to go to these things, they start buying their tickets now. In fact, when I posted this, one of our listeners did say, oh yeah, I've already ordered my tickets. So here's the thing. So Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party tickets start at $75 in advance or $85 at the gate, if available. The dates for this is going to be August 17th, 24th, 28th, 31st, and then weekends of September and throughout October. And there's more days every month of it, but it's coming, of course, and it's going to be beginning in August. They're going to have some returning treats, including the Hocus Pocus Villain Spelltacular, which, of course, goes on in front of Cinderella Castle. And, of course, the Boo to You Halloween Parade, the Happy Hallowishians, fireworks display, candy, lots of other stuff. And, okay, so this is also this other thing. The new Disney H2O Glow Nights, that's happening over at Disney's Typhoon Lagoon. And that's part of this Incredibles summer celebration. And some Toy Story characters are going to be throwing these glow parties, inspired, of course, by the Pixar short Partysaurus Rex. So this is going to be fun. Costs are going to be $55 for adults, $50 for children, 3 to 9, of course, plus tax. All right, so this is going on Thursdays and Saturdays, June 21st through August 11th, from 8 to 11. If you want your tickets for this type of thing, 407-939-1872. All right, and of course, I did mention Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party. This is going to be kicking up right after the Not-So-Scary Halloween Party, starting November 8th. Tickets for this, of course, start at $95 in advance and $105 at the gate, if available. So you're going to get Mickey's Once Upon a Christmas Parade, Holiday Wishes Fireworks, the Frozen Holiday Wish, all kinds of different stuff. This, I would love to actually go to this one because I love Christmas, and seeing it in the parks would be fantastic. I'm sure it's a lot better than trying to watch the Christmas parade on television. All right, so let's dive outside of the world of Disney real fast to say that things are actually happening for a Mask movie. Mask, you might remember from the television series and toy line in 1985, where you had characters, they put on these really kind of cool masks, and they had vehicles that converted into different types of vehicles. Like the main one was kind of this red, oh, kind of a DeLorean, but when the doors opened up, thing, they became wings, you know? So it was really, really cool. But we've got a director here. The director who did Fate of the Furious, F. Gary Gray, is now tapped to bring the series to theaters. And there are reports from Deadline that said there's going to be also a Men in Black quasi-reboot starring Chris Hemsworth and Tessa Thompson. And so during that, he closed the deal with Paramount and Hasbro to bring Mask to life, also known as Mobile Armored Strike Command, back in the 80s. Okay, so we talked about this with one of the Techno Retro Dads. We had Shaz Bazaar on, I want to say at least 2 years ago, a long time ago, to talk about this toy line. If you want to be able to hear it, it's not going to be available on iTunes. My people who support on Patreon, I do unlock old episodes for them there. So if you'd like to hear that, you're going to have to join the old Patreon there to get the old episodes. So, okay, I'm trying to move as quickly as we can because I know I got such a big thing. But we have another toy line coming to films. Variety reports that Aaron and Adam Nee are going to direct He-Man and the Masters of the Universe. So, we've also got some producers. Escape artist Todd Black, Jason Blumenthal, and Steve Tisch with Devin Franklin. There is a big article here in Variety. I'm going to dive into it real quick because I actually didn't look at the full article. I just got some of the stuff. But really, we don't know anything more other than these two guys are going to be helming it. They're a directing team. The pick has actually been written by David Goyer. You're going to be familiar with him. He's written a lot of different films. Just look him up. I mean, stuff like, you know, Batman, and I think he even wrote the original Spider-Man. So this is shaping up to be something really good to kind of bring He-Man back. I mean, right now we've got a She-Ra animated series coming to Netflix. And so now He-Man and the Masters of the Universe returning to movie theaters at last. Now, one last thing, back into the Disney parks. The Disney Store is, as they say, going green here, you know, starting here or just a bit ahead of Earth Day, so they've already been doing this, but they're not going to use the plastic shopping bags. Actually, that's going to be apparently going to begin on May 20, this coming month. This is all the retail stores here in North America. Today, Sunday, April 22nd, when I'm recording this, the Disney stores are gifting the guests an exclusive Disney-branded reusable bag as a gift with purchase while the quantities last. And then guests are going to have the opportunity to purchase a Disney-branded medium or large reusable bag for 99 cents. So this, of course, is trying to be a bit more green. You're going to have a bag which, you know, I have some of these reusable bags. I never remember to bring them anywhere to a place that has reusable. So it's nice they have some plastic bags around. And actually, I like to keep the plastic bag that I get from the store already. Because it's kind of cool, so I tend to hang on to the bags, so I'm glad I've got one. It's going to be like a collector's personal item. It's going to have personal meaning, I guess, to me. So, Yeah, Disney Store today. If you're hearing this and you didn't go and pick yourself up one, you've missed out. I'm tempted now to run over and get one. Although, I mean, it's just a 99-cent bag. But I kind of just want one because it's this Disney branded reusable bag, and I like reusable bags. I got a ton of these things already, though. I got reusable bags from about everywhere. I even got them from my university. But that is everything that I looked up this week. There's a ton of things. I could have probably gone on for hours just talking about all this stuff. But as it is now, I just want to turn it over to Yehaa Bob. Sorry I didn't have a little bit more detail on some of those news stories or anything more interesting to say about any of them, but I was, like I said, I was trying to rush because this is over an hour long, and I really wanted to get to the Yehaa Bob concert that I know you're going to love it. I haven't even gotten to hear this audio, so I'm excited to listen to it myself. But here we go. Eric and his wife at Port Orleans and Walt Disney World at Yehaa Bob. Enjoy!
To Disney and beyond!
I'm ready. You ready?
Yeah!
We're ready.
Of the Chicken Gym Center, so they can be sure.
in your life. On their 37th wedding anniversary, Tammy and Blair stand up for the... in here tonight, bringing all the kids to stand up and start jumping up and down and waving their arms in the air. This is important. Now that all the kids good, and now we need everybody else to stand up and start jumping up and down and waving their arms in the air. Come have a seat. It's more fun when you sing along, and I could use some help. We're going to start with our theme song. We have a theme song. It's from the Disney movie Bob. It's the time of your life, so live it well. We're solidified. I want you to sing along with me. I'm going to teach you to. It goes like this. The time of your life, living well. That you can help me sing.
It is the time of your life, so live it well.
We've only gone this one time, far as I can tell. It's the time of your life, sing.
So live it well. It's the time of your life, so live it well.
Like a song, it's not a song.
It's the time of your life, so live it well.
We've only gone around this one time, far as I can tell. It's the time of your life, so live it well. You're easily a bit surprised how the fortunes come and go. Don't wait till the enterprise does the magic fortune go.
Live it well.
Help me sing every line.
It's the time of your life, so live it well.
Thank you.
Neverland. Look at you, Teddy Blair. After you, Calendar. After you. Oh, we need some hands out of Neverland. Let's go. Shout out as loud as you can. Where you're from, I don't care where it is, as long as it's loud. And we can use some hand rubbing something out. Let's go. I'm that baby. And it's ladies, take you to the line.
Get shut up where you guys are from.
Canada.
Any plans for tonight for Canada?
Yeah!
Okay, so the next new people. Look out.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
song is extremely difficult. I am going to attempt a very complicated song. I always mess it up. I could use help. We need all the kids to stand up right where they are. Including middle school, high school, and college age kids. Especially 6th, 7th, and 8th grade. And now we need every one of you to come right down front and help out with this very difficult song. And you are going to have to concentrate. This is difficult. Those of you in the audience, no laughing, no talking, no eating. This requires concentration up front. Attention, please. Everybody face that way so they can see you turn around. Look at Mom and Dad.
Hey, here we go.
We're gonna make it.
Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama. Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama, Weeba Wama.
I give yourselves a hand, that's all you want. Are you sure my hair's got messed up? You get shut out where you kids are from.
Oregon!
You gonna say tonight from Oregon?
Like no other king before, pushing up on
looking down and practicing my roar. Roll out and the pot, gonna swing, help me sing. Oh. I just can't wait to be king.
Bird, the nice object. dancing away.
I'll make a brand new sign and then
wave. New York, New York.
I want to be in the city who doesn't sleep. In the end, there's nothing more to solve. But I need some help, Mary. We need all the girls, all the ladies, young and old, and the whole joint to stand up right where they are in New Jersey. Right. That'd be all the girls, and that's what I say. All the girls, including girls up in Harbor Rico.
And now we need everyone to come right down front and get the nice long line.
We come and we fill to we shack, drink up, and I go home. Marauder,
Cause we're leaving our country behind. Yo ho,
yo ho, 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 a pirate's life for me.
Sing!
Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me.
And he creeped us creep in the tombstone screen. Spokes from the upper a swinging ring.
Happy hearts materialize
and begin to vocalize. Creepy ghosts come out to social eyes.
Close your eyes and try to hide. The silly spook might sit by your side. Shrouded in the dark skies,
he pretends to terrorize.
Grim, grim ghosts come up to socialize. Back in the 1960s, there were these great songwriters who worked directly for Walt Disney. The Sherman Brothers. Here's a couple songs by the Sherman Brothers. I might stump you on the first one. See you, Nova.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow's just a dream away.
Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart.
And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great
big beautiful tomorrow.
Sing it for me.
Shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow.
Just a dream away.
Somebody
shout out where you can hear that song.
In the tiki 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 room,
all the birds sing words and the flowers croon.
In the tiki 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 room,
welcome to the tropical hideaway, all you lucky people. You, if it weren't for the show starting right away, we'd be in the audience too.
All together in the tiki 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 room. In the tiki 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 room,
all the birds sing words and the flowers croon.
In the tiki 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 room.
Oh, the Sherman Brothers, I know you know this one. Help me sing. Just a spoonful of sugar helps and medicine.
Go down. Go down. The medicine. Go down.
Just a spoonful of sugar helps and medicine.
Go down. In the most delightful way.
Here we go!
Turn around, slam the door. me can't get to me along. It's time to see the light.
Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. And good old boys drinking. whiskey and rye.
Singing the summer. I'll give yourself a hand.
Everybody to stand up right where they are.
Help me, everybody on that side. Can everybody on this side to know what to do? This. Punch your left foot in.
Punch your left foot in.
Punch your left foot in.
Then you shake it all around.
You little hook punch.
Jerk yourself around. Left foot roll up.
Right arm.
Right arm in.
Punch your right arm. Punch your right arm in.
Then you shake it all around.
Here's what off this crazy wide CD that I'm desperately trying to get rid of.
I'm gonna play a song that doesn't even have a Japanese imagination. And imagine a bumblebee flying around the room. Here comes the flying of the bumblebee. Go check this. That's your mom.
Thank you.
Everyone would be in love with me. you new girls just came in. Where are you kids from? In the corner. Where are you guys from? From any bus here tonight from the UK?
Thank you. everything going around the room. I need you to lead the train around the room tonight. The young lady right here in the middle, I need you to stand up correctly. You're gonna be. It's gonna be your job to pick up more cars as the train comes around. Everybody gets on. Oh, Kathy, don't go too fast.
Yeah. Are you sure my hair is okay?
Look straight, Bob!
I want to give everybody that wants one of these very handsome pictures. We got a new show in just a couple minutes. But it is time for our big whiz-bang grand finale, and RJ and I cannot do it by ourselves. We need all the boys, all the guys, young and old, in the whole joint to stand up right for the other boys. That'd be all the boys on that side of the room standing, and all the boys, including the boys in the bar, and no choosers. Every one of you to come right down front and help out with our big whiz bang grand finale. Come on, boys, you'll never see these people again in your life. And we need all the girls to stand up and clap their hands for the boys. My girls! Come on, boys! Guys! Boys, first you gotta point that way, then point that way, then point that way. You'll figure it out. Ready? Point! You can. This one needs to fit all the sandy up from half after. You want to fit all the sandy up next. Pick yourself up the ground. There's no need to be a mirror. There's a place you can go sandy up next. If you're the one you know, you can say it. I don't shoot you in the butt. Maybe raise your hand. Oh, good time. I was watching your shoes. I was down in the blues. I found nothing. Yeah, I was alive. One of these handsome pictures, ask about the CDs. I'm desperate to unload. Come with your email on the email list. Oh, thanks for thinking of me down here. We know there's so many things for you guys to do at Walt Disney World tonight, and we're thrilled that you would spend the night with us. It's a privilege to be with you tonight. My name's Bob. We got a new show in just a couple minutes. We love you guys.
Thank you for listening to the Neverland Podcast.
We invite you back next week for more fun and adventure.
Until then, remember to keep a pixie in your pocket.
It's that young at heart, positive attitude that you can share with others.
And remember to visit our website at neverlandpodcast.com.
There you can find links to our news page, our shop,
our contact page, where you can easily send an email to podcast@neverlandpodcast.com.
You can also find our Neverlanders page, where you can find out how to become an official Lost Boy or Pixie, because girls are too clever to get lost.
Become a real Neverlander.
please feel free to leave us a voicemail at 816-226-6492.
And be sure to follow us on Twitter at NeverlandPCast.
And like our Neverland Podcast fan page on Facebook.
We also have a group on Facebook for you to join.
We also appreciate your support to keep the Neverland Podcast up and running.
Visit patreon.com/neverlandpodcast to donate to keeping the pixie dust alive.
Copyright content featured on the Neverland Podcast is copyright of their respective creators and used under fair use license.
All original content is copyright of Blue Band Productions, and a very special thanks to Yehaa Bob Jackson at yehaabob.com for our new ending music.
God bless!
Yeah! Hello, everybody, this is Yehaa Bob Jackson. Neverland Podcast, we love you. Neverland Podcast, we love you. Neverland Podcast.